Tad Smith has thousands of reasons to get up each morning and head to the airport.
Make sure they grab these frames.
As a beekeeper for more than 75 hives, not too far from the runways at Chicago's O'Hare International Airport, Tad has to harvest the honey and keep the hives clean and safe.
I love the fact that the bees that I take care of put food on the table for people. Bees are responsible for 1/3 of what we get in this world. And so if we lose bees, we lose people. So to me, I'm keeping the world going. I'm keeping people alive.
But there's more to Tad's story. After serving prison time for a felony conviction, he was ready to put his life back together.
I knew that after I was returning home, I knew that I needed a job. It's a black male, 48 years old, and a felon. It was going to be hard. So I was looking into programs where they would help me out.
Programs like Sweet Beginnings, helping those released from prison re-enter society with a job and a purpose.
We knew that we had to do something different to establish, give them a chance to establish work skills and basically help to reduce sort of the fear and stigma that society has around folks who've served time. So we created a business that was intended to hire men and women with backgrounds and landed on honey and honeybees and our skincare products that are infused with our local honey.
And that's where the airport comes in.
We were approached actually by the CDA, the Chicago Department of Aviation, as a part of their green sustainability program. And they were saying to us, would you be interested in having a hive or two out here? I said, sure, how about like 50 to 100? And so about 4 years ago, we established that partnership and we've been growing our apiary and creating jobs in this partnership very successfully for the last 4 years.
Not only are the hives the first major apiary on airport grounds, but the gift shops inside the airport sell their honey products as well. More than 1,600 pounds of honey have been produced at O'Hare this year alone, which the beekeepers process and package.
They can play a role not only in helping to educate people about the importance of green and honeybees, but be part of jobs creation at a time when our country is really still sort of rebounding from a really difficult recession. So to be about jobs creation and also about producing honey in partnership with the airport, where otherwise this land would be unused, is I think quite wonderful and really remarkable.
Clifford Covington, who served 11 years in a federal penitentiary, would agree. After 83 interviews, he was told by a potential employer,
you are a number and that's all you'll be.
But he found a job with Sweet Beginnings. And to prove his critics wrong, he worked his way up to assistant general manager in just a matter of months.
Today, I'm standing here today free, and I am a name, Clifford Covington.
Honeybees don't distinguish between what we see as a flower or a weed, but that what they're interested in is drawing the good out of that plant source, right? And transforming it into something that is sweet and good. And I thought, wow, that's sort of what we're trying to do here.
And it's working. Virtually all employees have avoided reincarceration.
Even in life, even the bees have a lot of dangers around them. But if in order for them to exist, they have to continue to go on one path, the path that they given. If they stray from that path, they may end up somewhere they don't want to be. So in life, if I stay focused and keep on driving and keep on driving no matter what, I'm going to make it. And that's what I learned about the bees.
Holly Furfer, CNN, Chicago.